Hello everyone, I am Brian Mullins the Fox. I'm about to make a video which will be regarded the longest of its type individually in a long time. I had a documentary idea a long time ago that I will now disregard, which revolved around the same concepts, points, and arguments that this video will now deliver for you. The truth about the very foundation of family is that all of it is/was in vain. Here are the 16 things I will be discussing in this long-winded commentary video. Either they are categories of the five main factors that keep family alive in the world as a concept and structure, which I will mention in a little bit, or they are examples of the very points being made in the first place. And here they are in chronological order. Number 1. Sacrifice. Point 1. The roast game. The problem with Christmas, giving, and the value of self-worth. Number 2. Sacrifice. Point 2. Living a lie, and only dying the way you were born, or in vain. Number 3. Sacrifice. Point 3. Killing for your beliefs. Religious, national, political, etc. Number 4. Consensual silence. Point 1. Saving face, even for yourself. Number 5. Consensual silence. Point 2. Conspiracy. Number 6. Consensual silence. Point 3. Loyalty, faith, and whataboutism. What about the skeletons in your closet? Question mark. Number 7. False idolization. Point 1. All children are special. Rant segment. Number 8. False idolization. Point 2. You are better than everyone else. Number 9. False idolization. Point 3. Nobody's perfect. Number 10. Abuse. Point 1. Sexual abuse, pedophiles, and predator hunters. Number 11. Abuse. Point 2. Physical and emotional abuse. Number 12. Abuse. Point 3. Mental and psychological abuse. Number 13. The soft bigotry of low expectations. Point 1. The education system. Number 14. The soft bigotry of low expectations. Point 2. Religion. Number 15. The soft bigotry of low expectations. Point 3. Family itself. And finally, last but not least, number 16. Conclusion of all of this. Finale, which is a chapter or segment of its own autonomy. The five basic concepts that all families of all backgrounds, religions, etc. seem to follow indirectly or directly. Number 1. Sacrifice of any and all kinds, even if it means sacrificing their own children for any reason whatsoever. 2. Consensual silence, hush-hush agreements, and or hush-hush disagreements, etc. Number 3. False idolization of children, family, and peers. Number 4. Abuse of any and all kinds. And number 5. The soft bigotry of low expectations. So without further ado, let's get on with this and happy trails. First, let's get into sacrifice, starting with point 1. The roast game. The problem with Christmas giving and the value of self-worth. This first example encapsulates the very first basic concept of family and how they remain alive as a whole. The roast game. This past phenomenon is an example of a few things and the reason why these few things are known to be true / common sense now. Number 1. How not to idolize or put a holiday on a high pedestal. 2. How not to idolize children for no such good reasoning, which I will touch upon in a much later point. 3. Why Christmas never truly had a set-in-stone dinner tradition. Number 4. Why Christmas was and is never really that special. And number 5. Why dying for nothing doesn't really mean anything. What my dad has taught me, when it comes to the whole story surrounding Jesus Christ being born in a manger, and all that religious bullshit, is that the people, whoever they may have been, are perfectly comparable to Keystone Cops. Apparently, Christ came to life for the first time in a manger. He dies later, says that he's coming back to spread the word of God before doing so. Then, he comes back to life again and says that he will be there, dies again, pretends to be the messenger of the word of God. Then, with holes in his hands, coming back to life for the third and final time, and with everything that is ass backwards with his character, dies on a cross for nothing, crucified in vain. The main point of pointing out how hopelessly retarded the story surrounding the supposed birth of Christ is, is that it's the most inconsistent story that is idolized so vociferously that family is embedded in it. It is so needlessly forced into family culture that it's impossible to avoid. Giving gifts is not a thing someone should do. It would be nice to give someone something, but it doesn't matter if the person didn't want it, earned it, or deserved it all along. Your child will never be worth that much, or no one will ever be worth that much. Even if that child or person means everything to you, it does not matter how much of a conforming, self-degrading consumer you really are or need to be to make those arguments in support of giving gifts. Christ didn't give his life away for nothing, did he? Or didn't he? The value of self-worth is subjective, prone to change, character, consistencies/inconsistencies with moral values, and how and what they desire to act or do. If you solely value your self-worth over the amount of gifts you give or how willing you are to not just not question the idiocy in consumerism, but conform yourself, then you devalue yourself, thinking that you're never enough and that you're never going to be enough is the problem. And the only reasonable solution to that is stay true to yourself and question what you believe as you grow up. Before I move on to point two of sacrifice, I will let you all know that this isn't the only problem with families. Sacrifice is the reason why you can't be you, if you tend to and when you start a family. If sacrifice is necessary for families to remain and keep their keystone liabilities alive, the way they die will at least have all of us acknowledge and understand the reasons why they died. Moving on to point two, living a lie and only dying the way you were born, or in vain. Imagine living a lie and having been ashamed of yourself since the time that you were made aware of how much of a fucking mistake you really are as a human being. There is shame in being who you're not and what you're not, because you're at least tangentially aware of who and what you truly are. The problem with dying in vain is believing to have ever lived knowing you had faith in something that either doesn't or never existed, or never was true in the first place. Another problem is to live with inconsistent or completely false beliefs does not mean you've never lived as a moral human being down the line. The aftermath of having taken your life basically for nothing because you were essentially raised to die will be excruciatingly painful to fully consider without losing respect for that individual who believed to have something right in or with them. The response parents will generally have will be somewhat deadbeat in nature, as it's also in past tense, meaning that they're part of the problem that their son or daughter couldn't be fucked to live with or solve themselves. Now moving to point three, killing for your beliefs. Religious, national, political beliefs, etc. Killing for your beliefs is essentially the entire point of sacrifice for family. A family cannot and will not survive without sacrifice because of three things. A. Loyalty is key. B. Aggression is key. And C. Silence is golden. Whether it be you in the military or killing innocent Iraqi citizens having falsely believed that there were weapons of mass destruction, political or assassinating the character and making the lives of your opponents a living hell, if vociferously vindictive enough, and/or for anything else or any other reason, whether it be for Christmas dinner of Christmas past, for knowing you've only taken your life because you lived a lie, or just for the sake of sacrifice itself. Without the needless reason to sacrifice at all, families cannot and will not exist in that kind of environment. Now, moving on to the second concept, consensual silence. Consensual silence, point one, saving face. even for yourself. The problem with refusing to take criticism that's negative towards or completely against the family slash families you're defending is that saving face is not worth the attempt to argue at all. Saving face is the weakest non-response ever devised by any closeted hypocrite that has ever existed in the real world, on the internet, and in closet spaces. White knighting, in defense of the very concept of family as a whole, is just as problematic, if not more so, than unabashedly defending the very degenerate antics people outside of these families engage in that you've sworn to be vociferously against to begin with. It is absolutely asinine that families who engage in wrongdoing or be built or predicated on a lie are put on a high pedestal alongside with the other families that aren't so lucky. Remaining silent keeps them together, but consensual silence makes it that you'll lose their trust or lose them entirely if you go against it slash them. Consensual silence is inherently by design, because modern parenting is nothing more than a scam and a sham based solely on lies, false beliefs, moral inconsistencies, corrupt and shady practices, and sacrifice. If nobody kept a secret, no group will ever suffer a greater consequence other than the disbanding of said group. Point 2. Conspiracy. This is the most important part of consensual silence. Conspiracy to cover up evidence of wrongdoing by a family or family member, be it a murder, rape, etc. And even if they weren't too focused on shutting people up in online circles about phenomena like the roast game, what priests get caught doing to children in churches and other shit like that, they are too focused on assuming that the opposition are nothing but conspiracy theorists or conspiracy nuts. Gaslighting is key when it comes to crushing doubt towards the supposed integrity of family in general, because if a home is built by the wrong person with the wrong beliefs, skin color, moral codes, or even opinions, burn the house proverbially. Everything has to be perfect about them. Oh no, guys, there can't totally be anything wrong with them. Herb derp, I'm a family fool. If that was someone's opinion, I'd tell them to shut the fuck up, because that person had nothing of value to say when they said that. Conspiracies when it comes to the concept of family is central to any family's ability to keep the more important truths, shady secrets, and shitty facts about them hushed away, even if it means killing yourself to safeguard your family's name and bloodline. Consensual silence point 3. Loyalty, faith, and whataboutism. What about the skeletons in your closet, question mark? You can never be true to yourself if you had something in turn to give. Loyalty is 100% key when it comes to consensual silence. Faith comes second. Whataboutism comes last. And this is what really pisses me off about families in general. Just because I addressed the skeletons in your closet does not mean that you should, in return, do the same thing to me in an attempt to shut me up and shut the conversation down. Because if that's the game you people ought to play, then no conversation with any of you would be necessary. Because when you trivialize your history by making it all sugar-coated, la-di-da and shit, and you come after people who try to get the truth out of it, or at least reframe it to where it's as closest to the reality behind it in the first place, you prove two things. One, you're afraid of the truth, and two, you can't handle the truth. Now moving on to the next chapter in this commentary video. False idolization.